My name is Sean. I'm a houseplant enthusiast from Jakarta, Indonesia. I like to care for different types of houseplants and figure out their care and propagation in my home and then share that experience with you here on YouTube. So if you're into that kind of content, please do consider subscribing to my channel and send this video a like. In today's video, I'm going to talk about the caladium. And I know I have two very sad looking caladiums here. And some of you may click away, but hang on. I'm actually going to do a very long video today to show you how I induce dormancy on this one. So this one is actually in my first houseplants video where I talked about my first few houseplants, and I got it as a pretty decent plant, but it all died off completely and I threw it in the trash. And then this tiny leaf came out of the trash because I didn't take out my trash apparently, so I just left it there, and I'm thankful for that. So that little leaf has taught me that plants have a strong will to live, and we should be patient, we should give it some time, they will recover. And then the tiny little leaf started giving me like crazy massive leaves in the next 3 months. So yeah, that's actually my a plant that really has taught me a lot of lessons. And this is the same plant. So from there it went dormant and then it came back. And then I show you in my balcony video, the huge leaves, and even give me a flower, a really fat, phallic looking flower. So what I'm going to do with this guy is actually to just leave it alone. I'm going to keep it out of the rain. It's living outdoors right now. I'm going to let it dry out even a little bit more and give it slightly lower light. So these leaves, this is actually already yellowing and some of the leaves are showing signs of stress. So I'm just going to let them decline. It's going to be dead above the potting mix. However, keep in mind that the tubers are very much alive. And when you let them rest and you let them come back in a few months' time, they will grow huge and crazy leaves, so just be patient with them. I'm going to show you the process, of course, and with updates, so just bear with me. And before I talk about this caladium, maybe I'm going to quickly talk about the care, which is what I should have touched on earlier in the beginning. But caladiums, they love direct sunlight, and I would even say full sun. If you don't give them direct sunlight or full sun, they're going to give you this sort of green looking leaves. This is supposed to be vibrant, like a lot of whites on the leaves. So when you grow your plants, just kind of stick them in a bright location. Don't stick them in full sun yet. And because you don't know what conditions they were grown in before you got it, so you don't want to shock it. But believe me, they really need that direct sunlight. So you want to give them direct sunlight and then see their leaves get wider and wider, see them do well. And you have to just leave them be, let them stay where they are, where it's bright. If you keep them in lower light, of course, you're gonna get all green leaves. Like some of these baby leaves are actually all green. So I've kept this plant actually in a bright indirect light location outdoors. So yeah, apparently that light is not enough for it. The next thing that I wanna talk about is the watering. So they can take a lot of different types of potting medium. However, caladiums are actually quite thirsty in my opinion, especially if you give it direct sunlight or really bright light. They're going to be drinking up all that water fairly quickly. I actually have to water this guy every day because it's getting very bright in direct light, and I can see by the next morning the top of the soil is just completely light brown in color. It's just dry. So I amend my potting mix with a lot of perlite and burnt rice salt. I use my general purpose potting mix, by the way. And yeah, they seem to like that. So do not let them dry out completely. Do not have them sitting in water, but just keep them kind of moist, but not soggy wet. I don't really have any pests on these guys. I fertilize them the same way I do with most houseplants I have, with slow release, worm casting, and occasionally I would spray some grow more chemical fertilizer. So here's the thing with caladiums. All these are actually solar panels. They're gonna draw energy from the sun, and then they're gonna develop bigger tubers, and they're also gonna grow sideways. So it's gonna give you more and more tubers. I'm gonna see if I can take this out from the pot. Let's just show you guys. This is actually a little bit root bound, but I'm not gonna repot it yet. It's still got room in there for the roots to grow. For me, this is the right amount of root boundness, but not enough for me to repot it. I see some mealybugs, very, very small amounts, so that's fine. But this is a very, very healthy looking plant. Again, I just watered it this morning, that's why it's a little bit wet, but by the next day, if it's a hot and sunny day the day before, the potting mix will probably be dry up to like 3 to 4 centimeters. So I would always just water it every day. If you have this indoors, which they can do, by the way, they can live indoors, but they still require that bright light. You want to water them less when they're indoors. And when you have yellowing leaves that fall off, that's a sign of overwatering. Or maybe that leaf, like this one, is probably just really old and tired. It's done its job and it's ready to move on. Yeah. So there are also a lot of varieties of caladiums. A lot of them come in shades of pinks, different patterns, and they're just so beautiful. And I believe that caladiums are having a moment right now. It's going to become the next syngonium. So keep an eye out on caladiums. If you see one and it's a good price, I would definitely say get it. Here's about 10 days later. As you can see, I kept the media pretty dry. I water it very, very lightly, and a lot of the leaves has already died off, which is a good thing. I'm just gonna let it completely die off and then keep the pot a little bit misted once in a while, lightly watered once in a while. Just to make sure that the tuberous is not completely, like, I don't know, dried off. Even though I know some people do store them in shelves over the winter. So this is 5 weeks after the first video. The leaves died out, I think, about 1 week ago. I did slow down with watering, but I do water it lightly once in a while. So let's look at what the tubers in there look like. Ah, very tiny. Cute. It's still hard, it's not mushy, so must be doing quite well. Let me feel it for more. There has to be some more. Is there anything in here? Nope. Yeah, there you go. Now we're talking. So this is that second tuber. It's trying to put out a new leaf, actually. This is what the new leaf looked like. It's actually a little bit deep in the pot. This is buried a little bit too deep. So I'm actually going to let this, like, hang out. So what happens is that they actually spread sideways, like in the soil. They push out, like, I don't know, roots or whatever, something that connects them to the next tuber over, and then the new tuber would form, so they would grow horizontally underground. Oh, I see, I feel another one. Very cute. And I guess it's very obvious from these which side up they are. There you go. Some people actually store them in a closet over the winter. I don't know if I should do that or not. Now, I think I'm going to pot it up, and then I'm going to keep it slightly on the dry side, give it a little bit of dry period, but not dry out completely, because I feel bad. Like, there's actually some roots here that seem to be very healthy. Okay, so I found a pot here. I guess it's a pretty nice size pot for this plant. I'm going to be keeping it very, very root bound. I may actually add a little bit of furadon. This is a pesticide, because I don't want anything to be living in here and eating on the tubers. Sorry, is this a tuber or a bulb? I think this is a bulb, sorry. I shouldn't have called it a tuber, sorry. I'm not gonna fertilize this. I'm gonna do it when I'm trying to wake it up. Welcome to a 1 month update on this caladium. And actually, I did a whole film. I filmed this whole thing, but with my mic off, so I'm refilming it again. I originally shot this indoors, where I kept this plant. So basically, I watered this every 2 to 3 days. I kept it very lightly watered, which means it's not bone dry, but it's not soggy wet either. And then this thing up here, this little thing, is trying to come back to life. So I hope that it's a big leaf, but we don't know yet until it opens. And I finally kicked it outside, so it's now just moved out here. And I put a little bit of worm casting, that dark brown stuff, that's worm casting, to give it some nutrients and nourishments to let it push out crazy big leaves, hopefully. And then they like full sun, frequent watering. They don't like to be dried out too completely, but they don't want to be drowned either. And again, they like heavy feeding. So I'm going to give you guys an update to see how this will do. So I'll see you. So we are at 5 months and 1 week since we started this project. It's growing so slow. Let me get you better lighting. This is so slow. You took a really long nap, didn't you? And I think you can probably predict from here that this is going to be a pretty big leaf. And I have it right here. And as you can see, This gets partial direct sunlight at this spot, and I do know that they got like full sun, so I'm gonna experiment with that too when this unfurls. But yes, this video is going to be all about dormancy, but I did figure out how to propagate these guys and it's super fun, but that's going to be another video on in another time. So yeah, I'll give you guys an update in a few weeks time. So this is 1 week since the last update. This is looking so beautiful. We put out this leaf. It is actually very small compared to the ones that I see in the nursery. This is about as big as my palm. Really love that little bit of defect there. It looks like someone took a marker and missed. This is very nice. It's got a very strong petiole, and look at that. It's putting out a inflorescence. This is so wild. I do want to take this off because I don't want it to spend all its energy on this flower. It's not going to pollinate anyways. And the flower looks really weird. It's like this strange rubbery thing. So yeah, I'm not gonna have that for now. And then look at that, below that, there's new growth. There's two new leaves coming. And actually, when you look at caladiums, these two sprouts actually came from a separate bulb, because caladiums typically would put out new leaves from the previous stem. So this is actually one plant. If this plant did not put out a flower before, it would probably put out a leaf from this sheath here. So this is how a caladium grow. So this is one plant, this is two plants, and this is three plants. So you can actually separate them later. And one of the tricks I read, actually I haven't really experimented with it, is to separate them to make sure that there's only one plant per pot, so that it's got its beautiful root ball, it's got the nutrients that it needs, and it's got obviously the right amount of sunlight. Imagine if this got really bushy, because these guys, they actually love, oh my god, there's a bee. These guys actually, they love full sun. So if you have so many of them growing like below this, they're not gonna get the optimal sunlight, which is why the ones that were grown lower below are gonna give you smaller and smaller leaves. So yeah, the key of growing these to be big is to propagate frequently. I'm gonna give you guys an update because I wanna see how these bulbs form below and show you what I'm talking about, but that's gonna take a few more weeks at least. I'm gonna wait for these leaves to unfurl. Here's a 3 months update. I actually neglected this plant because I moved, so it's been living in this new home for about 5 or 6 weeks now, and it didn't put out super white and big leaves as I would expect. Maybe because two things. One, it needed more light. I kind of had it grown there under a shelf. It's getting pretty bright in direct light with a little bit of direct, but I think it really wants that full sun. Another reason could be that it needs a little bit of fertilizing. I actually don't see any of my slow release fertilizer. Normally I would put a few slow release fertilizer in there, but I may have missed this pot. They do like to be fed a little bit. All right, so a moment of truth. I'm gonna take this out. I also have a feeling there may be some pest issues in there, which is why it's not really growing as fast. But I'm really glad, because you remember that they have these two other little growth points. They did put out leaves, so everyone is doing fine. And just to show you here, this is where the new leaf comes from. So they would break off from the petiole of the last leaf. So if you want to cut this leaf off, make sure you leave a little bit of the stem here, especially on a newer leaf, so that new leaf can emerge from here. So let me take this out and see what happens. Oh, and by the way, this is a very thirsty plant. Oh my god, see? What did I tell you? What did I tell you? Look at that. This is covered in mealybugs. This is actually not very root-bound yet, if you ask me, because I like my plants to be very, very root-bound. Although I feel like they can benefit a little bit from having a slightly bigger pot size. And yeah, the mealybugs really cause them to stunt. So if your plant is not growing well, stunted, check them for me. This is one of the worst mealybug infestations that I've seen. So I'm going to go ahead and treat this plant with mealybugs. But I'm not going to give you guys another... Hang on, you know what? Before I let you go, I want to see if I can show you the inside. I want to see if it's developed more corms. Alright, that's way too many mealybugs. But this is the main leaf, the biggest leaf that it has. It didn't give me any bulbs or any corms, so I expect more to form. However, remember that there were three plants in there, and now there's four. Look at these three. So one of them is new, probably this one. This is the smallest one. But I want to show you, look at how sexy this is. Look at that. It formed its own bulb. And here, actually, you can chop this bulb up. And if you see some growing eye here, they will give you multiple plants. I see like a little nub here, but that's another video for another time. I'm going to show you how to, first of all, I'm going to grow this out bigger, and I'm going to show you how to chop this up and turn this into many, many plants. So yeah, thank you so much for watching this video. I'm a botanist on Instagram. If you want to DM me on any questions regarding plant care and propagations, I do post a lot of the updates on my Instagram as well. So I'll see you there. Meanwhile, do take care and stay safe. I will see you in the next video. Bye. Thank you.